What is up, you guys? AFK here, back with another art tutorial. Now, this one is pretty much, I'm not going to be showing you all my tips on how to draw and how to paint, but as you can see, we have Neptune back, and we're going to be coloring her with Copics, watercolor, and stuff like that. So I just wanted to let you guys know what I'm going to be using, where you can buy it, how much it is. So let's go ahead and hop right down to it. Alright guys, as you can see, I have my Copics lined up. I'm going to be showing you guys, I'm going to be telling you which ones they are, how much they are, and I will put the link, I will put them in the description on which numbers they are again if you miss. But you're going to need E00, E11, E13. I picked up these two yesterday. It's BV13 and BV17. They're purple and a darkish purple, but they're classified as a blue, so you can pick those up at Hobby Lobby. Each one was about $7, but with a Hobby Lobby coupon, it's half off, so you can get them for about, I'm not really sure, maybe about $3-4, depending, you know, on where you are and stuff. But those are the colors that we're going to be using to start off with, so let's go ahead and hop right down to it. Alright, I'm back, and we're going to go ahead and get started. I just wanted to show you guys how to use Copics in general, but everything else I'm going to speed up because it's time consuming to talk through everything, and you know how that is, people with YouTube. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to zoom in here for you guys so you can see clearly what I'm doing. We're going to start down here on her lower cheek, but you want to go in a circular motion. You want to use your lightest color first, but you want to work fast but slow at the same time because it does dry. I'm using watercolor paper, so it doesn't dry that fast, but if you're using regular marker paper, it will dry pretty fast. So you just want to start up here, and you just want to work your way down in circles, just like this. And you want to kind of get everywhere. Do not color on your ink too much, or the black lines will smear. I've done that in the past, and it's very annoying. So that's a helpful tip, that you want to color smoothly, but you want to color evenly too. You don't want to have too many spots that are just white with, you know, no color in them. So you want to just be careful of what you're doing. Be cautious and aware. For the eyes, you want to leave a spot for where the color and stuff is going to be all the time. So you just make those little indentions there, and you just basically work your way up. You just work your way up through the top of the page to where her hairline is and stuff, and you just gradually get a little looser every time you go up, obviously. The best thing about Copics is I think they're alcohol based, I'm not really sure, so the ink spreads really fast and it spreads very evenly, so you don't really have to color, you know, like a long time, like as you would with like a Crayola marker or something. You can just go over it one time and it's pretty much there. And you just do the same thing with the ear, because you add effects and stuff to the ear and stuff pretty much after you're done inking. But that's pretty much how you color. So I'm going to zoom out for you guys real quick and add some details. You want to go ahead and you want to move up to your E11. Sorry, that was a little hard to close. And with your E11, I'm going to zoom back in here, you're going to want to just lightly go across where the hair is, because that's going to be kind of like the shadow. Here, and over here towards her ear. Alright guys, well that's pretty much how you ink with Copics. I'm going to speed up the rest of the picture. I hope you guys enjoy. Leave a like and subscribe.